Hi everyone, Wo Kelly here. In this video series, I'll be narrating a 16-page manuscript that contains an interrogation of Karl Dönitz by the Allies after World War II. This report contains information such as his personal background, the history of the U-boat campaign, questions about the German naval air forces and other naval forces, the mine-laying activities of the Allied air forces, and more. Section 1. Personal background. Question. Give us a short description of your career. Answer. During the last war, I was on the Breslau in the Mediterranean and in the Black Sea. Later on, I was with the submarines. Then I became torpedo boat commander and was later on the staff of the naval station in Wilhelmshaven. Subsequently, I became skipper of the cruiser Emden, and after the London Naval Agreement in autumn 1935, I was charged with the training for the new submarines and also took over the operations of the U-boats. That was my job until January 30th, 1943, at which time I was appointed Commander-in-Chief of the Navy, succeeding Grand Admiral Rader. Section 2. The History of the U-Boat Campaign. Question. Will you describe the war program of the German Navy in general? Answer. That is difficult for me, inasmuch as I had charge of the submarines only at the beginning of the war, and having been through the first years of the war as a captain at sea, as well as in charge of training and operations of the U-boats, I cannot tell you very much about the general plan. After the summer of 1935, that is, after the London Naval Agreement, our Navy started building different vessels of the types permitted, including U-boats. As far as I can remember, we had about 48 U-boats at the beginning of the war. I'm not entirely sure of this number, because I'm quoting from memory. It is the number of submarines which were the potential operational fleet. The number that actually went into combat was, during the first months of the war, so small that in some months we only had 2, 3, or 5 submarines simultaneously in the combat zone. Question. How many submarines were there in addition to the 48 which were ready for operational use? Answer. Unfortunately, I do not remember that number anymore. You must bear in mind that our Navy was in the stage of being built. That is, the ships which we were permitted to build according to the London Naval Agreement were not yet ready. Question. Can you give us an approximate number? Answer. I just know of those 48 submarines at the time, but I'm sure that the documents concerning that must be in Kiel. Question. What was your plan to increase the number of submarines? Answer. With the beginning of the war, a U-boat program was formulated. According to this plan, we wanted to build 15 to 20 a month, which should later have been increased to 20 or 25. We did not reach this number, 15 or 20 a month, until 1942. It took a long time to build these U-boats and to train the crews for them. Question. Will you give us this production program periodically throughout the war, including the number of U-boats built and those operationally available? Answer. In general, the ratio is such that of the submarines available, one half will be in the docks and the other half will be on the seas. Out of the latter ones, again, one half will be in the combat zone and the other half on their way to and from the combat zone. We had about 2 to 8 ships in the combat zone all throughout 1940. I can best illustrate this by a story which was being told at the time. I had under my command 2 brothers, both U-boat officers, each one serving on a different U-boat. It so happened that these were the only U-boats at sea at the time, and people would say, "The brothers, so-and-so, alone are winning the war for Germany." This story illustrates how small the number was, because the Navy was in the process of being built up. In 1941, we managed to get 8, 12, 15, or perhaps a maximum of 20 submarines simultaneously in the zone of operation. In 1942, this increased from that to some 35 to 55, and in the winter of 1942-43, we had perhaps 70 to 80 U-boats simultaneously in the zone of operations. You will understand that these are only approximate figures. We had then reached a climax in the submarine warfare in March or April 1943. At that time, we suffered a very sharp reversal from which we never again recovered. That was caused by the Anglo-American Air Force, with its improved radio location equipment. From then on, the submarines on the surface were detected and your planes could both fight them and notify and divert their convoy. Question. Give us the number of operational submarines in the combat zone from April 1943 onwards. Answer. The numbers that I've already given are the numbers in the combat zone. From April 1943 onwards, we had very severe losses, and the numbers had again dropped. It came down again to probably 50. After April 1943, losses were much higher, and the new construction could not keep up. For instance, in May 1943, we lost 42 submarines. Our total was then 22 less, because only 20 were built. 1943 marked a decrease in our submarines and fewer successes. Towards the end of 1943 and beginning of 1944, there were 30 to 40 submarines in the combat zone. I had then decided to build a new type of submarine, which did not need a surface, because I know I was beaten by the aircraft as long as I stayed on the surface. When I started this production, the number of U-boats in the operational zone suffered through that again and came down to 20 or 25. I let the old submarines run out of production gradually and started building more and more of the new types. The drawings for the submarines were made in the summer of 1943 and completed in December 1943. The boats were then built in 1944. They included two types, a large one of 1,500 tons and a small one of about 300 tons. At the time of the capitulation, we had about five of the small ones, Type 23s, in the combat zone, and of the larger ones, Type 21, only one boat went to sea and it did not reach the combat zone. Question: how many submarines of the old type were in the combat zone at the end of the war? Answer: there were about 18 or 20 of the old types, and those were modified by the addition of the snorkel. That was a sort of air mast which enabled the submarine to stay underwater. Question: how many of the old types were fitted with the snorkel? Answer: just about all that went into the combat zone. That would make about 120 altogether. Question: what was the number of submarines built from the beginning of the war to the end? Answer: I believe that the exact number was turned over to your authorities in Kiel. It will probably be some 1,000 ships. I arrive at this figure by calculating that our losses were some 600 U-boats by the end of the war, and we had about 400 left, including those under construction. Question: where were these U-boats built mainly? Answer: Bremen, Hamburg, and Kiel. Question: which company had the best reputation for submarine construction? Answer: Blohm+Voss and Deschimag in Bremen. But there were very little difference. Question: what were your main types? Answer: a 300-ton submarine, a very small ship, with a very large radius. We called it the Type 7C. The other was a 740-ton U-boat, which we called the Type 9C. Those were the main types. Question: which type of submarine did you consider the best? Answer: Type 7C of 500 tons, the smallest and the best. Question: wasn't there a time in 1941 or 1942 when it was proposed to cut down the production program? Answer: that is true. It was said there was a shortage of copper, but this proved to be incorrect. Question: who is responsible for the suggestion to cut down this program? Answer: it was certain of Grand Admiral Reeder's advisors who thought that we did not have sufficient copper. Question: were you personally in agreement with this suggestion? Answer: no. The Grand Admiral was not in agreement either, and then an investigation revealed that there was sufficient copper for the program to be carried out in the old form. Question: if you could have gotten all the submarines you wanted, how many would you have built? Answer: I don't know because I don't know our industrial capacity, but I know that I would have built the same type of submarines. In any case, I would have done the exact same as far as the ratio between the Type 7C and the Type 9C was concerned. Question: where are the documents pertaining to U-boat construction? Answer: they're in the technical department of the OKM, which towards the end was in Hamburg. Question: whereabouts in Hamburg, and who was the man responsible for them? Answer: towards the end was Admiral Ruge. He was the chief of the construction office. After we evacuated from Berlin, different parts of the OKM were divided, and the construction office went to Hamburg. I assume that it got situated in the naval station there. Question: were there documents in Flensburg later on? Answer: no, but located in Flensburg was the operations department for the submarines. This was called the second department of the naval command. Question. Were those operational documents handed over to somebody? Answer. I'm sure that your commission were continuously in the offices of the Second Department. Question. Did you build any new heavy naval ships in 1941-1942? Answer. No. As far as I know, after the beginning of the war, only U-boats were built and what was needed to put those U-boats out to sea. There were no new construction of heavy vessels. In general, the ships under construction at the beginning of the war were finished, but not all of them. For instance, no aircraft carriers were finished. Question. At what time was the decision taken not to complete any aircraft carriers? Answer. I think in 1940, but I'm not sure because I was concerned only with submarines at that time. Question. Were other carriers except the Graf Zeppelin under construction? Answer. You would have to ask Admiral Wagner. I don't know exactly. Question. What difficulties in the submarine construction program were caused by shortages of raw materials? Answer. Outside of the alleged shortage of copper at one time, we had no troubles with raw materials. Admiral Fuchs would know exactly about that. He was the one who built the submarines. Question. What was the difficulties in the submarine construction program caused by the bombing attacks? Answer. The bombing attacks did not actually start until 1943 to any large extent. At that time, we were beginning to build the new type already. The new type were built in several sections in roughly cylindrical shapes. These sections were constructed in various plants, primarily in the Ruhr and central Germany. The parts which went into the sections were manufactured in plants throughout Germany. After a section was built, it was then equipped inside. When all the bowels were in, the sections were assembled together in Berlin, Hamburg, or Danzig. In May 1943, great delays in production were caused through the early attacks on the German industry. If in one of the sections, say, a pump was missing, because the factory that made the pump was bombed out, then the whole U-boat was no good. The shortage of one part often held up the construction of the entire section. We were also very much afraid that something might happen in one of the three ports, as that was where the assembly was made. But we were pretty lucky there up until the last months in 1945, when we suffered heavy losses in Hamburg and in Bremen. Question. Were these assembly places concrete covered? Answer. No, the assembly places were not protected, but we had some protected places where the bowels were built in.